jazz and blues and ragtime and gospel. We're going to start with this one. Neil on the end is going to sing it for you. And it's called I Can't Dance, I've Got Ants in My Pants.
The title's funny.
Yeah, it's a good start.
We're there. This is our kind of audience.
Killing jive.
So it's the double entendre songs, the metaphor songs. Quite a few single entendre songs in I noticed as well, but more of that later. So this is one of those songs, and it's called I Had to Give Up Gym. So Jim spelled G-Y-M, but back in the day, Jim was a nickname for something else. A male appendage, shall we say. Just in case there's any little ears on the live stream.
Yeah, it is before nine.
Yeah, this was originally recorded by a band called the Hokum Boys, who were kind of a collection, a band who got together with basically every time they turned up, they had a different lineup. So it's a bit like us, really.
Yeah, that's right.
Often happen. So yeah, we go out anything from a kind of three piece to a six piece, and you've got four today, so you know, average, standard. So here goes. I had to give up gym.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Miss Joanne used to take her days when she used to go to her list. In the shadow ground, her arithmetic and breath, she always did the best that she could do. One day she
You had 4 o'clock wine time, it is Friday.
You start early down here. So this one's called Champagne Charlie. Join in with that. Champagne Charlie is my name. So, Warren James on the banjo is going to sing you this next one. And this is a proper old jug band song. Do any of you know what a jug band is? No. So back in the 20s, when there wasn't a lot of money to be had, they couldn't afford lots of expensive stringed and brass instruments, so they decided they would make music using instruments they'd made at home, using things around the house like the jug as a bass instrument, the washboard as a percussion instrument. The kazoo was very popular. Frying pan banjos, do you fancy one of those? You're all right. So yeah, this was a really a big movement that was huge for about 3 years, started in the Deep South. when they suddenly started to have a bit more money again, they decided they didn't want to be associated with music that reminded them of being poor. So this kind of this music very quickly disappeared, and this jazz kind of took hold and took over. So yeah, it's that's the kind of jug band part in our name. The other half of our name I'll tell you about later. But this was a song originally recorded by the Memphis Jug Band, who were one of the very popular bands of the day, and it's called On the Road Again. Seven albums.
Only seven, Duncan.
And that's seven different albums, not seven copies, in case you're unsure. Although we'd probably be alright tonight, I think. But yeah, our latest album, Goodbye Booze, or our latest studio album, I should say, came out in March 2020, which, as we all know now, was the worst marketing ploy in the world. So we weren't able to get out and play lots of the songs from it. But we deliberately released it in 2020 because that marked 100 years since the start of the American Prohibition. So we thought this was something that was worth perhaps not celebrating, but more commemorating the event. So we put together this album of songs, all written at the time of the Prohibition, on various sides of the argument. And we put loads of extra session players on there. So Nick is actually decking with us today. Nick regularly plays with us from time to time. And we got him into the studio, and a few other people that we often play with, but you know, can't fit onto the stage. And yeah, we thought we were really happy with it. We released it, and they immediately closed all the pubs. Now, I'm not saying it was our fault.
No.
But, you know, there you go. So anyway, so we're going to play you some of the songs from that album today, and now we can finally get out and play. So this is the title track from the album, and it is called Goodbye Booze.
One, two, three. Songs from the 20s and 30s, a lot of them quite obscure.
this is one you may know, because it was a big hit much later for Connie Francis. And this one's called Who's Sorry Now?
Who's tuning up now?
Again, you did that last gig.
Not only that, I think.
Got my gear.
Just pick.
Yeah.
So we quite often play jazz clubs and jazz festivals. So when we get to this one, we usually go, are there any Fats Waller fans in?
It's all right. It's all right.
You don't need to be afraid.
It just eases the pressure on me.
If you don't know, Fats Waller was a very famous piano player. That was your job.
So we're not a Fats Waller tribute band then.
We're going to do it anyway. Also, there's a line in the original recording that Fats Waller did that said, "Up in Harlem." And for about the last 300 gigs, Neil has basically changed it to wherever we happen to be playing. Which is fine, depending on the place name.
We're at Ashby Del Zoo, aren't we?
Yeah, so it's going to be a squeeze.
So I might just drop that. Where are we now?
West.
Baggy country.
One, 2, 3, 4.
Who's that walking? Sounds like Baby Panda. Baby Elephant Panda, my boy.
Join in with this one. It's called Your Feet's Too Big. Feet. And this guy at the bar put his hand up and went, I went, what size are you, sir? He said, tens. I went, that's not exceptionally large. I said, I'm in 12s. I was expecting a kind of 17s or something. You know. He was keen. He just saw an opportunity. I'll pop my arm.
Well, that's the British way.
It is.
Join it is a quick animal.
This is how wars were started, unfortunately. So we're going to do you a song now, again, that was a big kind of jug band song, and it's called Be Lum Bum. And it was one we recorded on our second album. We signed to a label called Late Records up in Cumbria, and it was on the first album that we did for them about 9 years ago, something like that. And we haven't played it since, until about 2 weeks ago when we did it in Coventry, at some coalfield, sorry. Is that allowed?
Yeah.
Close enough for jazz. but it must have gone all right because we're doing it again. So here it goes, Be Lum Bum.
One, two, three, four.
Memphis, Tennessee, there's a girl named Cindy. Runs a mean shop on the block, she's always got a pin.
If you like the way I think, listen to
Barbara on the washboard. Okay, we're just going to do one more and then we'll have a little break.
It's when they bring the caviar out. I shouldn't get too carried out. I've come from Coventry, the city of culture. I used to carry out.
Is that what happens in Coventry?
It is now.
So yeah, this is just in case you were thinking of checking out the merchandise in the break. We have, first of all, we have one of those authentic 1920s card readers, which is very good for that side of it. But also, this is the song that we always play out with to help sell CDs. It's a song about death.
Yeah.
So it's that kind of get 'em while you can. So it's called The Little Black Train. It's an old gospel tune. And we'll see you after the break.
Better set your house in order, for the train may come tonight. There's a little black train.
green ones.
Chuck me out, by the way.
You want me to have?
Shut up. This is your chance.
Oh!
So close.
I don't think I've got the right shaped head.
I definitely
don't. Almost up your stage, that's the first battle point. So we're going to start this second set with an old Hokum tune. It's called Quarters Doing It. We've dispensed with double entendre, we've gone straight to single entendre. Okay, we're going to do another Join Ye Innie one. Are you ready for it? Not really. We're going to do it anyway. I don't know. This one's called Keep Your Mind On It, and it's dead simple. It's call and response. We go, keep your mind on it, and you go,
keep your mind on it.
Just like that.
One.
That's enough. That's an army.
Yeah.
Here goes. I'm in love with everything, just a problem. usually say this is a warning song for the gentlemen in the audience. I don't know, anything you want to add? Or I don't know how your day's gone so far. This one's for anyone who needs it. It's called My Pencil Won't Write No More.
Now listen here, folks, and there's one thing sure. My old pencil won't write no more, 'cause the lead's all gone. The lead's all gone. The lead's all gone, and the pencil won't write no more. I'll lay down on my bed just to write a line, but that old pencil's giving me a bad time. It's all gone. It's all gone. Sidewalks are the best is written.
this next one, you have to join in with. The others kind of, you know, requested your participation. This one kind of demands it. And we can see you all here. So now's your opportunity. Dead simple again, call and response. You only have to say one word. What could be simple? That word is nuts. We sing nuts, you sing
nuts.
Slightly louder than that. You sing
nuts!
That's the kind of thing. Hot nuts, get them from the peanut man.
Oh yeah.
Thank you.
So yeah, this next one, I talked about earlier about the jug bands and where they, how they came to be. So the other half of our name, if you were wondering, Jake Leg, it's not anyone in the band's name. And it's actually an ailment, going back to Prohibition times, and when they couldn't legally buy alcohol. And those that were, you know, buying moonshine and things like that, were getting their alcohol fix legally by buying something over the counters in the drugstores, Jamaican ginger extract. Or Jake, as it was nicknamed, and it was about 80% proof, but for medicinal purposes, obviously. But yeah, the kind of makers of this stuff realised that this stuff was selling in bucket loads, and they could make more money if they diluted it down with other things. One of those things was what happened is it gave the regular drinkers of this stuff a paralysis of the lower limbs. But we're back to my pencil worm right now, more again. But it also gave them a rather distinct walk or swagger, which they called the Jake Leg or the Jake Walk. So this is one of the songs that was written about it at the time because it was a huge scandal, and obviously this was a topical song. So this one is the Jake Leg Blues.
One, two, three, four. You know that you move your back.
cell wall, then you can pardon and set free. Now, I don't think that's going to work in prisons today, but it's a nice thought, isn't it? Very romantic. It tells the story of it. When you wake up in the morning, hear the ding dong ring, go marching to the table, you hear the same damn thing. Nothing for the round the table. Nothing in my pain. Cause if I complain about it, I get in trouble with the men at the midnight train. Shine a light on me.
Thank you.
So this may be one of those Hokum songs again. It's called Greasy Greens.
Soon as I get good, I will go.
Because I like to think that 10% might be too high.
Right. Could you guys bring me in on it?
Yeah. Gonna leave you with this one, and it's called He's in the Jailhouse.